Tamiya is just, does not give a fuck. She just straight up does not give a fuck. She's freaking there, grabbing babies, fucking go to straight up using them as shields and stuff against freaking parasites and all that. Like, yo, Tamiya, you're just a sick ass freaking bitch. Like, you are probably the worst mom of 2015. You were just straight up like, who fucking just go running around, dragging a baby like that, and just freaking like, oh, I'm using it as a shield, fuck you. So we can see mainly in this episode of Parasite, a lot of setup and a lot of philosophical talk and all that. I'm liking that as the episodes progress on, like, Parasite is just getting a lot more deeper and just a lot more into, like, the characters and all that. It's like, we get to see, you know, straight up in this episode and all that, the investigator, like, we get to see, like, Shinji's, like, trying to talk him out and stuff like that, because he's, like, sounding crazy. Like, when he went to talk to Tamiya, he was, like, sounding like a crazy person, and Tamiya's like, you know, please, I'm calling this off and all that. It's like, yeah, I'll pay you for what the work you've done already, but this is, like, ridiculous and all that. I'd see as well, like, when Shinichi, he also caught on the hands of Joe and all that. I was surprised that we was even going to see any more of the, like, the big guy with the jaw and all that, Joe. And it was like, yeah, that's kind of awesome to see more of him and all that. It's like, and he was helping him, and he was trying to look like freaking Elvis with the glasses and all that. And it was just the way how he's talking and all that. And Miggy explained it right and all that. Like, what can you have, like, say, oh, you're going to use Shinichi as a lab, right? You're going to, like, make him, like, help defeat the parasites and all that. And it's like, what right do you have and all that? Like, as Miggy, very interesting. Like, this is the most deepest we've probably seen Miggy. And we're seeing that definitely that these two are now sharing emotions and all that. Like, Shinichi's turning more into, like, a parasite. And Miggy's turning more into a human, saying, you know, we have rights and all that. Miggy would normally just say, yeah, I'm killing you. Like, I don't give a fuck. That's just instincts and all that. And he was just saying, you know, we have as much as right to live than you do and all that. And it's like, and you're so kind of like a justice and like everything that you do and all that is like rights and all that. Yeah, they're kind of taken to the extreme and all that in certain places. So it's like, Miggy's done, you know, its homework and all that. Saying, you know, we have rights to live as well as parasites. And we're just trying to live and all that. And it was just like, damn, like that was kind of some deep shit and all that, just hearing it from it. And even as well, when we saw Tamiya in this episode, I was like, even she is getting more human emotions. Like, we actually get to see, like, when she saw that person, like, on the floor really getting upset and saw that he was in pain and suffering and all that, she was actually laughing and chuckling and all that. I was like, god damn, she's actually starting to expose her emotions. She's like, wait a minute, I should actually try and, you know, do the face for it as well and all that. And it's like, she's just a straight up fucked up bitch. And when Shinichi goes to confront her and all that, I was like, oh my god, shit's gonna kick off on the rooftop. And she's there, like, listening to her straight up, like, chewing her, like, saying, oh, about, like, parasites and all that. Like, she was just straight up hearing her talk about animals and all that and their instincts and their, like, maternal love and all that, saying, you know, this is the selfish gene and stuff like that. And it was very interesting because Tamiya is learning all about this, and it's like, it's true for Parasite. I mean, yeah, they're the exceptional cases, but we've seen Tamiya, like, sometimes she cares for the kid and all that, and, like, sometimes she, like, just, like, straight out uses it. She also, in a way, like, Tamiya as well, she's breaking out of that sort of, like, just that instinct role, and now she's actually starting to feel with emotions and stuff like that, because that's one thing with the parasites and all that, that they just think on, like, just raw instinct at first, but now that they've been growing and developing and all that, like, they want to become mayor, they're finding other different ways and all that, because originally they'll just be like, oh, we don't care, we're just going to kill and all that, we just need to eat to survive, that's all they were, but since they're just a continuing, evolving organism, it's just very fucking interesting just to see that, and I really do like that. I thought that was a really good thing for them to actually even do in this episode. I thought, damn, that's some really fucking, like, good shit to do. And it's just like, when she just got on Shinichi's nerves, saying, yeah, oh yeah, your mom died and all that, it's like, and she's like straight up laughing about it and it's saying, like, Shinichi's like, I'm gonna fucking kill you, and she just holds the baby and they have to leave it off there. And even when he starts saying, move out of the way, humans, like, Shinichi doesn't really consider himself, like, human anymore and all that. It's like, even, like, he's kind of gone to the point of acceptance, saying, yeah, I'm not human, I'm not normal, like, screw it, I'm not the same as everyone else and all that. And the ending of the episode, we get to that weird fortune teller saying, you know, the best way to close the heart and all that, like, with this pain that you're suffering in your heart is by, like, using, like, you know, seeing that person one more time. It's just Shinichi laughing and just, like, saying, I killed that person. I was like, you told you straight, you killed your mother, that's just fucked up. Like, Shinichi's like, yeah. Like, as Tamiya kind of breaks out of her shell a little bit more, like, Shinichi's, like, just closing himself up to the world and saying, yeah, I'm a fucking parasite, I don't care, I'm infected, But one thing I can say and all that, and it's a little bit off-topic and all that, I will say that I'm happy that we still got the opening. Like, I hope that stays. I guess until next week and all that, we won't know unless it's changing or something, but I hope it doesn't change. yeah, maybe you could go a little bit with the ending and all that. I mean, I really like the ending. I think it's a beautiful ending, but it's like, most of the time, if we're not going to have a different opening stuff, so yeah, like, that's just either way. I'm like, I really want to keep the opening. The opening's so fucking cool. Overall, this was a really good episode and all that. I thought this was, like, great setup and all that. I'll give this a 7.5 out of 10 and all that for the episode. It was, like, just good setup and really philosophical. But it did feel like a little dragged at some points, and I will admit as well, the art was kind of, like, it was kind of meh at some parts of this episode. So, yeah, 7.5, I think that's a good score for it. So, let me know in the comment section down below, but what do you think about this episode of Parasite? But that's all for me, so thank you very much for watching as always, and I'll see you guys next time.